So you just got some brand new headphones and you rip through the package, you put them on, and they clamp like a medieval torture device. So what do you do now? Do you return them? Do you try and push through the pain that only gets worse every second? Is there anything you can even do? If that's your problem, then you are in the right spot, because my name is Andrew Dandrew, and I am on a mission to search this entire wonderful universe for answers to the most important questions, such as what do I do when my headphones clamp too hard, and explain these answers to you. So let's see how we can fix your very tidy clamping headphones. Generally speaking, headphones should clamp your head quite firmly. You don't want them to clamp so hard that they hurt, but you don't want them to just dangle on your head, because achieving a good seal around your ear in the ear cup is very important for both frequency response and noise isolation. That's why, for example, ear protection earmuffs clamp so hard, because no air needs to be able to escape or enter your ear cup while you're wearing them, otherwise they just won't work. And since headphones are meant to accommodate heads of all shapes and sizes, sometimes they can clamp a little bit too much. And surprisingly, this happens more often when you have a smaller head, because when you're wearing your headband on a smaller setting, it has a lot more clamping leverage. So the first step in fixing this problem should be making sure that you're wearing your headband at the proper setting. Ideally, your ears should be exactly in the center of the ear cup, fully surrounded by the ear pad. You don't want the ear cups to either hang on your ears or pull your ears upwards. You should only feel a gentle clamp force. If the clamping you feel is way more than gentle, even with the headband correctly set, it's time to try and stretch your headphones over some books. Grab a stack of books that's 5 centimeters or a couple of inches wider than your head and stretch your headphones over them. You need to be very careful because you don't want to end up with a broken headband, especially if your headphones are made out of plastic. After positioning the headphones on the books, it's time to leave them there for the books to do their magic. And it could take anywhere between 3 and 10 days for the headphones to get stretched, depending on how tight they are to begin with. You don't want to get them too loose, you want to get them clamping just right. In my case, it took about 7 days. You can start by stretching them when you're not using them overnight, but if it takes more than 10 days, maybe you want to accelerate the process. And this means taking matters into your own hands by stretching or forcing the headband to stretch using your fingers. This procedure should only be attempted with heavy-duty headphones that have metal headbands. This means most studio headphones. Some of them are hybrid. This means that they have a metal headband but also have some plastic. And this procedure could also work for these, but you have to be extra careful because you don't want to break the plastic parts. The last thing you want is to end up with broken headphones. So, needless to say, for headphones that are fully made out of plastic, you should stick to the books. You don't want to break them, just stick to the books. But most heavy clamping headphones will be made out of metal anyway. So when stretching a metal headband, you want to get rid of any cushioning that's easy to take away. Then you grab the metal with both of your hands and you use your fingers to pull towards you while using your thumbs to push into the headband, forcing it to stretch. Now, smooth movements are the best. You don't want to jerk the headband, you want to slowly increment the force. And if the headband has two elements like my headphones have, make sure to do it for both on one side, and only then switch sides. And when both sides are done, you can move upwards towards the top of the headband until the entire headband gets stretched. After doing this entire process once, put your headphones on your head and check for the clamping force, because it's very easy to stretch them some more if needed, but it's very hard to compensate if you overstretch the headband. So be very careful again. If everything went well, you should now have a much more comfortable set of headphones, but there's still some room for improvement. Remember how when you have your headband set at its largest setting, the headphones clamp less? Well, if you can make your headband cushioning thicker and you can wear your headphones like this, you're gonna clamp even less. To do this, you can use some extra cushioning that wraps over the existing one and makes the headband essentially thicker. I happen to have this piece that kind of fits over this headband and doesn't look too way out of place, but if you don't, there's a link in the description where you can get some extra headband cushioning that you can use to make your headband thicker. If you don't care too much about looks and you're all about comfort, you could get creative with some sponge and some zip ties. Just wrap the sponge around your headband and secure it with zip ties, and this will definitely raise the headband up, allowing you to wear your headphones at a larger setting. By now, that very tight clamping force should have went away, and you are now free to break in your ear pads and your headband cushioning, and with time, your headphones are going to become very, very comfortable. But if after all these steps, your headphones still feel kind of uncomfortable on your head, maybe they're just not for you. So you could try and look for a different design, or maybe try and tackle other parts, such as the ear pad. Ear pads play a very big role in comfort as well, and they're oftentimes the first thing people try and mod on their headphones. But when changing ear pads, you're gonna change the sound as well, in desirable or undesirable ways. If your headphones come stock with pleated pads and you swap them for some more comfortable textile or velour ones, you're gonna lose a little bit of bass frequencies and some noise isolation. In my case, this isn't really an issue since I'm going to use these for a speech and I don't mind the loss of bass and I don't need extremely good noise isolation. But the point I'm trying to make is that ear pads are a very complex subject that would require a standalone video. And this might happen here in the future, but that's for another day. Another idea would be to mod them to include a suspension strap, AKG style. This design is one of the most comfortable, and when paired with very light headphones, it turns into a pleasure to wear for long hours. This is something I'm actually planning to do to the Superlux just for fun, but this will be another video in the future. Until then, I hope this video helped, and I hope you enjoyed it. Again, my name is Andrew Dandrew. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, maybe click the like button and maybe subscribe to the channel and ding the bell so you can be notified when I upload a new video. But until then, I hope you have an awesome day. I hope you'll have an awesome week, and I'll see you next time.